for Jesus. For every second you have spent on it, I want you to thank Him. I want us to thank God for every second. God, I thank you for every minute. I thank you for every hour. Thank you for every day. Thank you for every week. Thank you for every month. Thank you for every year that I have spent in the land of the living. Lord, I am not taking the grace for granted. And so much thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For every prayer that I have taken in, thank you for the life of my joy. Thank you for your favor. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your kindness. We have exalted, O Lord. We magnify, O Lord. We magnify, O Lord.
And their officers said, "You
shall no more give these people straw to make bread. As heretofore, let them go and gather straw for themselves. And instead of the bread which they did make them, therefore, heretofore, you shall lay upon them. You shall not diminish aught thereof, for they shall be idle. Therefore, they cry, saying, let us go and sacrifice our money. Let their own work be laid upon the man, that they may never bear him, and let them not regard being waste. And the taskmaster of the people went out, and their officer, and they spake to the people, saying, thus says Pharaoh, I will not give you strong. If you read and you read and read, you will realize that the same pain that they ask for their freedom, the same day that they make up their mind that they want to serve them, that they want to go to this wilderness to sacrifice peace unto their God, the same day the enemy increase their affliction. Here is somebody that is here. The same day that you make up your mind that you want to serve them, the same day that you say, no, I am not committing sin again. I want to live a holy life. I want to serve God for the rest of my life. The same thing, God will kill whatever you are enjoying it. The one that, I mean, the devil will kill whatever you are enjoying it to afflict you. Are you here?
Yes,
ma'am. I said, she wants to serve God. The money we are giving you, we will collect. The position we are giving you, we will make sure we drive you away. It's either they implicate you, or they afflict you with one terrible sickness. The God make sure they afflict you from that shame. If they increase the name and you are going through affliction, the same thing that happened to Israel, that is what you are going through now. Are you here?
Yes.
He said the same day, he said, it's because they ask for, don't give them again. We know everything that make life easy for them. The devil has taken away those things that make life easy for you just because of your decision of serving him not. Just because you have made up your mind that you and your household for the rest of your life you want to serve God. Just because you make up your mind that those who have said, me and my children will serve him not. That is why the devil is throwing this out. That is why you are receiving all this wrong around you. If you read further, they started crying. They said, what have we done? That is going to make our life miserable for the rest of our life. And they said, it's because you are free, that is why you want to go and serve God. It's because you have peace. It's because you have good eggs. When you have your eggs again, when you are sick, will you serve God? Will you be able to fast? When your home is on fire, will you say you want to sing praises unto God? And you only achieve this for God. She will wake up in the night, she will begin to sing and sing and sing and sing. It's because she has peace. And then that walk away, go back, baby, grown up. Let the family gather and conspire. Oh my God. If somebody is here, you have this knowledge today. The same day that you make up your mind that you want to spend your money, I want to sacrifice, I want to beautify the house of God. I want to change the altar. Yes. I want to paint the church. I want to buy land. The same thing your business will start going down. She told me no one who will come to church. I don't know where she come. Now you are facing the difficulty. It's as if you are the only one. You are the only one. The God that set the Israelite free is still on the throne.
Family. And now we are builders. And this is what I want you.
money. You don't need to get money again. Any money I have now, I want to be eating. Don't relax. Let me waste it. Let me wait for the time of your future to multiply your affliction.
Say it out.
Maybe I should buy seed in the arena. Maybe I should leave the church. Maybe I should go and join another church. Maybe I should leave this prayer center. I don't know. You don't even tell anybody, but within you, you are saying the same thing. When this power particular affliction, they will increase stress. You have seen that in the life of Israel. They increase trouble. They afflict people with sickness. They cause disfavor. Why don't we never receive favor around them? They will call disfavor in the life of Christian. Amen.
Amen.
Because you are the one that want to serve God. Even people that you are praying for, they will see what will benefit you. They will not even give it to you. You are the one praying for them. It's the devil. Did you hear me? I say it's the devil.
Yes,
your husband you are praying for can come back and say you are the enemy. A man called him one day and said, please, I know you are a prophet. I want you to pray and ask for who is my wife. I said, your wife? Only you can get a man to you. A man money. I want you to just pray and let God show you who she is. After this, I decided not to pray. Because I knew when they married. I knew he was not. And I know now he has built one or two houses. And he has cars. So why would I ask them? The woman has still got to three children. Why would I go on my knee to ask who the wife is? So after a few days, and I knew he married the lady as a virgin. So after a few days, he called me and said, what did you say? I said, I did not even pray. Say, what is happening to you? What is happening to you? What is another new person? I said, is it this time you want me to go and pray to know who your wife is? After all these years, after how many years of marriage, you have 3 kids. Money, no money. The wife told to enrich now. So Otajelika told your parents from the crash. And again, the lady was telling me, no, we are building the first house. I took loan of 500,000 from my bank. When we are building this, I took loan of 400,000. And even last year, I got a letter from 400,000. Immediately, I transferred. For you to just do whatever you want to do with it. And move everything. Come on, come here, leave me, move it, bash it. You are going to enrich. Every power that wants to turn every woman here to enrich. Now you're supposed to sit down and begin to enjoy what you are never for. The Lord shall strike those power. And I don't mess with me and tell you that again.
Thank you.
Moses is their savior. But affliction plagued them to turn against me and say, ah! May God judge you! And look at this one, amen. We don't need that.
Thank you.
our life needs now. All what you are asking this flesh of yours and your blood to do to now is to go to the root of every foundation and destroy evil plantation.
You must wear the garment of your Lord. Thank you.